lectionary is a rotation of scripture that guides our thinking each week. And the lectionary texts offer four options each week. And there's one from the Hebrew scripture, there's two from the Hebrew scripture, one is a psalm always, and then one other. And then there's always a gospel reading, and there's always an epistle reading. And so I told Erin I want to make the Genesis text that she just read be in dialogue with the Matthew text. And so I'll read the Matthew text. I'm going to read it from the Common English Version, if that's okay with y'all. It's Matthew 11, verse 16 to 19, and then we're going to jump to 25. So if we think about the story that we just heard, Isaac and Rebecca, how might this connect with that? Jesus is speaking. To what will I compare this generation? It's like a child sitting in the marketplace, is calling out to others, "We're playing the flute for you, and you didn't dance. We sang a funeral song, and you didn't mourn. For John the Baptist, came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, he has a demon. And yet the human one came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton, a drunk, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom is proved to be right by her works." And then jumping to 25. At that time, Jesus said, "I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you've hidden these things from the wise and intelligent and have shown them to babies. Indeed, Father, this brings you happiness. My Father has handed all things over to me. No one knows the Son except the Father, and nobody knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wants to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are struggling hard and carrying heavy loads, and I will give you rest. Put on my yoke and learn from me. I am gentle and humble, and you will find rest for yourselves. My yoke is easy to bear, and my burden is light." The word of the Lord. So Abraham sends a servant to find his son a partner. That's the story. And this servant sets up a hope. You heard it, right? "Please, God," he says, "send a woman to give me some water, and then have her also be so kind that she gives water to my camels too." Right? That's the sign he wants. And that's exactly how it happens, right? So easy. And the servant goes back with Rebecca to her father and mother. He asks for her hands, and they say yes. Again, couldn't be easier. And then there's a little pushback, but the servant wants Rebecca to come right away. If we have read it from the bigger, from the adult level, right? The parents ask for 10 days, but the servant says, "Oh, no, no, please let her come today," right? And then Rebecca says, "All right, I'll come today," right? So she agrees. So I'll go now. Again, it's all the servant hoped for. Everything in this story is so easy, right? It sets up a premise that if God wants something to happen, it will work out. God will provide. God has a plan. God will work it out. Now listen, we all know that is not how the world seems to work, right? Things don't seem to work out easy all the time, right? And actually, when it's God's time and God's place, things do work out, is what I hear the text saying. Even though we have a lot of experiences where life is a lot harder, it doesn't work out. And so I'm wondering if what really we need to wonder is this the right time? And is this what God's doing? Because it seems like if it's the right time and if it's what God's doing, then it kind of works. So we've been creating this living library over the summer, right? I've been planning to interview a different person from our congregation each week as a way to highlight the wisdom that comes from all of us, right? Here at Grace. And so this week, rather than interview one person, I thought I would highlight the start of our wellness center, right? So, because it was easy, if I can be honest. So here's the backstory, if you don't remember, right? There was a dance school that was renting our space, and they were paying us $14,000 a year, and they totally outgrew us, right? And they found another place. So all of a sudden, we needed $14,000, right? And so rather than go out and just find a renter right away, right, I asked the session met, and I said, "Let's just give it 1 month. Can you give me 1 month to think and pray with some people and ask, maybe God wants us to do something ourselves in our community instead of just renting the space to an outside group," right? So I looked around our congregation, And I saw that we had a fairly large group of people who worked in the healing arts, I would say, right? We had a doctor, we had a nurse, we had a couple of massage therapists, we had a yoga instructor, a life coach, a couple of therapists, right? We just happened to have them, right? So I said, you know, I'm gonna get all those people together, I'm gonna serve them lunch. So if you were in that meeting, which some of you were, raise your hands. Yeah, so Lori and Gary are here. Janice was here, I'm looking around the room. And Gabby's here, she's in the nursery.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Gabby was here, Marianne was in the room, Irene was in the room. So it was just eight of them, whatever I just listed, right? So I'm glad that a couple of you, so I might put you on the spot, but you don't have to remember, but. So we got together, right? These people are part of our living library today, right? We gathered for lunch and I asked them one question. If the session asked us around this table to start an outreach in our community that could also make money, what would we do, right? And we spent to that, right? That was the question. The session is asking us, I want you to start a business that's an outreach to the community. So what are some of the, do you remember from those first couple months, some of the things? Do you remember anything from the conversation of like how it went, or do you have a feeling from it? Do you remember?
I think you said, you know, doing yoga and massage, and I can't even remember what else.
Yeah. Yeah, I think once we were on the table, we were like, well, this is what we do, you know, which was intentional on my part. Yeah, you guys kind of all have something in common, right? And so at first they're like, we'll call it the well, I think, right? And then I remember Gabby was excited and we came up with a website, so the original website was feedingallwhohunger.com, right? Which then became annoying that it's not Sandhills Wellness Center, and so we changed it. But you know what I mean? Like, so that was like our growing thing. It's like, how do we feed people, right? Well, what if we have programs that are mind, body, and spirit, right? Was a lot of what we were thinking, right? And then we had to do research on like, how much can we do in our building? Can we do like clinic stuff? Can we have a physician here? And you know, it turns out you need a little bit more like permits, and the rooms need to be a little different if you're gonna do things like that, right? But those were all part of our conversation, right? Here's what I remember, it was easy. Right? It was easy. Before, that meeting was in September, if you remember. We had our soft opening of the Wellness Center in March. And we already had recovered 12,000 of the 14,000 that we needed. It was easy. And it was a huge lesson for me. Don't get me wrong, right? It was hard work, right? There were a few of the people around that table took it as their part-time job. September, October, but to March. It was hard work, right? But there was a restful quality to the work. We weren't anxious in our work. We were just doing what was in front of us, right? It was a huge lesson for me about working with God versus working on my own. Or even harder yet would be working against God, which I think I have done also in my life. I'm sure you have too. Now, like I said, not everything is done easy like that, right? Even at Grace, not everything works out with restful work, right? I'll give you an example. We hosted the welcome table for a year, right? And a few people worked really hard and they sacrificed Saturday nights and tried to make it work. The welcome table was a great idea. It is a great idea, right? It's a place where people can share a meal and they get to know each other who are different than them. And it's like this really like ready-made plan, right? A small group of people really benefited from it. But it got hard. The work stopped being restful, right? And then we plowed through because we thought, no, it's just a good idea, so we should still do good things because God wants us to do good things, right? It is a good program, right? But we came to realize that maybe it's a good thing and it's just not the right time right now, right? And I'll be honest, Aaron and I are still very open to God guiding us. It is a good idea. Guiding us to the right time and the right place for this program. So how do we know then when things are the right time and the right place, right? So Jesus uses this image of a yoke in Matthew's text. He says, come to me, take my yoke upon you, and learn from me. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. Now, we wish the verse said, or maybe I'm just speaking for myself, I wish the verse said, Jesus, come to me and take my yoke upon you. Let's do what I want. Let's go where I want to go. Right?
No,
That's what we wish, but it doesn't say that. We have things we want to do. We want our lives to be easy. We want our burdens to be light. But that's not what the verse says. It says Jesus' yoke is what's easy. Jesus' burden is light. And so Jesus is asking us to bear his yoke with him. He's not promising to bear our yoke with us. So you guys know what a yoke is? It's a wooden beam, right? Probably, you know, this long or so. And it has two ropes, or sometimes made out of metal, but two ropes around it. And it's meant for two animals, often oxen is what we think of, to put their head through the rope, right? And then the oxen next to it has his head through the rope. And together they bear this, they're attached then. And so when one goes one way, the other one goes with it, right? And it enables them to pull twice the load together. The beam forces the two animals to stick together, to move at the same pace, to move in the same direction. And as a result, whatever load they are pulling is easier because they are doing it together. So Jesus says, take my yoke upon you. Learn from me. The word learn is the term disciple comes from, right? A disciple is first and foremost a learner. Take my yoke upon you and learn. Learn from me. Learn that my yoke is easy, my burden is light. The invitation to learn is more than just like a cognitive, I understand what Jesus wants to do in the world. It's an invitation to adopt a new lifestyle, to decide to work and move and go with Jesus, with my feet, not just what I believe or what I think in my head, right? It's adopting a way of life. To learn from Jesus is to walk with him, to go in that direction that Jesus is going in the world. And when we go in the direction of Jesus, when we do the things that Jesus wants to do in the world, he promises that we will find rest in that lifestyle. Rest. Not sleep, necessarily. That's not what rest means here. Rest. Rest goes back even in Exodus. God promises rest for the people when God promises to be with them, right? Moses was so anxious about the journey in the wilderness, and God said to Moses, my presence will go with you. I will give you rest. That's what rest means. Rest is about presence, not a lack of activity. Rest is about close proximity with Christ, right? Rest is about being close to Christ while we walk and work together. When we walk and work with Jesus, we find rest. Now listen, there are times when what we are doing are the things Jesus is doing, and it will feel like very hard work. Starting the wellness center was hard work, but there was an ease to it. There was a restful quality. We trusted the process. It made sense. This was obviously the right thing to do. We were at peace. We were at rest, right? And so our encouragement today is to yoke ourselves to Jesus, to walk with him in the world, to work with Jesus in the world, in close proximity. That's when we find rest and ease, where we find peace in our work. Amen. Let's sing as we bring our prayers to God.
Come bring your words to mind. as we bring our burdens and our joys to God, let us do so walking with Jesus, seeking to walk and work with Jesus and find rest. What prayers do we have this morning that we can lift up together? Yes, Debbie.
I'm sorry, I'm mixed up right now.